video, I'm going to show you the step-by-step process in which you can create your own online store. Yes, online store like Jumia, like Amazon, like Gigi, without actually spending a dime, without spending any money at all. So if you are interested in creating online store, can you stick with me to the end of this video? Do not skip any part. I'm going to show you the step-by-step approach in which you can create your own online store. Now, if you are new to this channel, can you consider subscribing, because I create video on how you can make money online and how you can actually be more productive in your businesses. All right, so let's get started without wasting our time. Let's go into it. So now I'm going to show you the website I'm going to use to create our online store for absolutely free, and the payment will be automated. The transport and the transportation, the shipping will be automated. Everything will be automated, so you don't have to do anything. All you have to do is just to present the store to your customer. They make everything. They make whatever they want to do on the website. Your own is just to deliver it. You know, now in this store you can actually deliver both physical products like clothes, like bag, and also digital product like ebook. So it's very amazing. So let's get started. Now I'm going to show you this website. Now first thing I'm going to do is just to open a tab and click and search for Paystack. So you can just put paystack.com. So I'm going to use Paystack to create our online store. As you all know, Paystack is one of the best fintech company in Nigeria and in Africa at large. So Paystack is also available in a large percentage of Africa. So we're going to search for that now. Okay, or better, you can just put in paystack.com, but I'm going to show you the step by step. So I'm going to open this first tab here. Okay, here we are into Paystack. So now if you are new to this channel, just click on this create a new account. Okay, if you are new to this platform, rather click create a new account. But I'm just going to log in. So I'm going to show you now. Creating a new account can be a little bit difficult if you are not guided, because you have to upload some little documents. So I've already created a video on how you can actually walk through everything. So just go to my channel and you locate this video. Okay, let me show you the video. All right, how to create a Paystack account. So I created some week ago. So this is the video here, how to create Paystack account. This is the easiest method, and how to even integrate it with any website that you have your resource. So all right, let me just close this. As you can see, just come around and of course just watch the video to know how to create your own Paystack account. It is very easy. All right, as you can see, it's playing now. It's just alright, this is just a simple, as I've seen the interface is also like this. Alright, so if you are new again, kindly click on the subscribe button to get subscribed to this channel. So let's go back into where you are coming from. So me, I've already created my own Paystack account. So if you're not created a Paystack account, I'll put the link available in the description box below. Just click on it and you will create your own free account. So I'm just going to log in. I'm going to click on login here to just log in into my own account. Okay, yeah, I'm logging in. So yeah, I am. So I'm just going to put in my own address and my password and I am good to go. Alright, so log into your account. So immediately you have finished creating your account to become live. So they'll send an email to you to make sure that you are the owner of the account and everything will become live. So you're going to have a dashboard like this. So this is my own dashboard looks like presently. Alright, so I'm just going to click. So what I have to do is just to come to the top here. This dashboard, click on the dashboard so that the menu here is going to open. So I'm going to click on this dashboard. So when I click on the dashboard, okay, all right, I think this thing is kind of glitchy here. Okay, let me click on that again. Okay, see, now I've clicked on the dashboard and it has opened up for me. Just go down and locate where they wrote this storefront. As you can see, storefront here, click on the storefront. Okay, all right, when you click on storefront, it should bring you. All right, so actually click on order, not order. So click on storefront, go back, then storefront. Yes, so it's from the storefront I'm going to create our own online store. As you can see, I've already created one before, which I called Daniel's store. So all you have to do is you just come to this, click create name plus storefront. You're able to see your own in the middle here. So yeah, I'm going to put the name of my storefront, then just call it computer store. Let's call the computer store. You know, now the currency, what do you want the currency to be? So we have two currency here. You can either choose naira or USD, but I'm going to choose naira because I'm currently in Nigeria. All right, so I'm going to choose naira. Then your store will have this link automatically like this, so you cannot do anything to affect this and it's okay. All right, so all I have to do is just click on create. Make me click on create. the website is going to create your store for you. All you have to do is just to insert, just to customize your store and insert any of your products. So I'm going to show you everything. As you can see here, so it will bring something like this for you. Now, I already created one of these products. That is why it has brought it for me this way. All you have to do is just to click on add new products. When you click on add new products, yours, it will give you a tab of where you can actually automatically add products. So here, I'm going to add new products. So yeah, okay. So now, for just for the to make this easy, I'm going to go to jumia.com and put in some products here. So you should have gotten your product, snap it and make so things become more easier. So let me just go to jumia.com here. I'm going to open a tab on jumia.com. okay, in case you don't know, you can actually make money on jumia.com. so I've created a video on how I make 500,000 naira using Jumia, because there are three ways you can make money on Jumia. I've explained those three ways in the video, so I'll put the link below in the description box. Just click on it on the description box below or in the comment section. You will see how I make money using Jumia. So alright, so let me just come straight to computer section, because I say it's computer, so I'm gonna come straight to where they put their computer here. Alright, so I'm gonna click on this menu. I'm just using Jumia here just to show you, okay, you know, this I'm just to show you how things is being done. Alright, so I'm gonna come to computing here. Click on computing. I just want to get products I can put on the store, so the store can be perfect, so you know how things is being done. I'm going to show you my one way of doing that. Alright, so I'm just going to come straight to anywhere they put computer. Okay, I think I've seen one. Alright, this, just going to open this and then put the video, the image, the description. So yeah, I'm just going to right click this and download image. Okay, of course, get download image. Okay, I'm going to close this. I will download up to, like, you know, two image or three, just to make my store so customer can actually have more options. So download this too. Okay, I think let me download this last one. Download image. Okay, download image. Now I'm just going to copy the description also. The description. So put that description. I'm just going to copy it. Let me open that in the new tab and copy everything that is there. So and copy it to this place. Just for the sake of this tutorial, copy. So let me check the amount. How much is it? I think it's 210,000 there. So I will go back to my store here. Okay, I'm back to my store I'm creating here. I just use Jumia to get to get a product I'm going to put on my store. Okay, so it is just going to load again, you know, stuff like that. All right so which one are we doing? Computer store. So just click on it in case that's close. Okay, not Daniel store, please. It's computer. Okay, I'm not going to press back. I don't want to put it on Daniel store. It's computer store. Okay, all right let me just go back to the place I am coming from. Okay, so this computer store, maybe click on computer store here, yeah? Just to make sure it opens the computer store. So it's still giving me Daniel's shop. Okay, sorry about that. Okay, so we're back here now. I'm just going to come to pull dots, you know, since I've already covered that, as in, you know, because I've already tried to go and get products, open a new tab, since I've already gotten it fresh. I'm going to click on products here. So I'm going to go back to where I can actually add my products. So when you click on product there, it will take you to this same place. Okay, just going to get it like this. Then click on add products. So when you click on add products, it's going to come up again. All right, so what I'm going to do is to come here, click on plus new products. All right, so what is the name of the product? Let me just give it a name. I don't want the tab to close again. Let me just give it HP computer. All right, then put out the description. When I copied all that time, I'm just going to paste it here. All right, then the amount, the price. Let me put in the price. So press this down here. Just take it up here. I'm going to write 21,000. All right, the quantity unlimited. Now, does it contain, now when you come to this tab, you can see these products contain one or more physical goods. Yes, which one is open, that it contains physical goods. So physical goods are like your computer, your shoe, your everything, but digital are like your ebook. So that being done, let's see that we are going to do here. We just click on next. Now when you click on next, it's going to give you the ability to be able to upload media. So I'm going to click on add media here, then go to my download tab, then just put this history, click on open up there. So it's going to automatically come over here. Okay, so I think you are good to go. Let's see, it's loading. So this is the three things I have actually added. So I should be able to move this one up, I suppose. Okay, alright. So you should try to make sure that you select them in order. So that means don't really click on save. Alright, so when the next thing I gotta do is to click on save. So when I click on save, you see we have already gotten one product here. Okay, so we've already gotten our one product here. Alright, so let me refresh this. Alright, so the product that appears, you can see you have one product here. So this is our computer. Now you can add more products, you know, to add more products. So just to save time, I don't want it to be so long. You can add more products as you want. So I'm going to add just a single product. You can add as many as you want, actually, not just one. So this one, I'm just going to include this because I've actually created this one before. Include it. Alright. And come down. Let me come down here and click on add products to store. So I can have just like two products. So you can have more than that if you want to. Of course, you should have more than one product. So we have added products here. Oh, next thing I'm going to do is to come to customize font store. So I'm going to personalize it to make it look more, to have this feeling of personal store, just like your color. If your brand color is like red, yellow, or green, or anything, maybe is at this place you can actually be able to customize it to the way you desire. Okay, so we'll click on customize store again. Here we are. So we are now in this place here. So these are my stores is going to look like, you know, something like this. And the color I'm getting here, okay, the color I'm getting here is blue. You can see it's blue, computer store blue. I can change it to, if I want to change it, I can change it now. If you want my store to be offline, just click on this tab to become offline. Now I want to edit the link, this computer, so I can actually edit this if you want to be. Now this welcome message, as you can see, they say your computer, your store font welcome message. You can just put in anything, you know, anything like let me say welcome to the best computer store in Nigeria. Okay, I actually add more if you want to. So when you put that, you can see it has changed. Welcome to the best store in Nigeria. All right, then you can do more if you want to. Of course, you should. Like for example, to change the color, just click on this change color here. Let's say I want to change the color to orange. So you can see it has changed, or to pink. But I think I like the blue. So I want to leave it as the blue here. You can change to any color, basically all this color. Okay. Now that being done, just come here and click on save. You have to save the test you have written. Now the next thing you are going to do is about your business. So you can just come here and write about your business. You can see this place here where they wrote about your business here. You can just click on it, tell us about your business. So now you can actually do more here. When you know about your business, you can make it bold, you know, stuff like that. So I'm just going to type something here, computer store is the foremost, you know, just make everything just fast. It's the foremost store in Nigeria and Africa at large, you know. Just do this basic combo. You can type more, you know, just more of what your store is all about. So I'm just come down here and click on the save. So there's a save button down here. I'm gonna click on that. So it's going to get saved. Now the next thing I can do here is, after I've put about your store, you can actually put your contact. So this is my email. I'm going to leave it that way. Social media. Now this social media, you can add your Facebook, your Twitter, and the rest. But I'm going to leave it this because this tutorial. So now we have to come to delivery. When you click on delivery, it's going to give you option to customize your delivery too. Okay, as you can see, we have spent nothing. Everything is just free. All right, so got that. Delivery address. Now, what you want your customer to actually put in when they're about to deliver, don't let them put in their delivery address, or don't let them also put delivery note. Now, you must know that it's important to specify the region to which you physically deliver order. So I'm just come here, this one, we'll click on required, of course, required. So I want them to put in their delivery address. And similarly, delivery notes. Don't let the people to put delivery notes. Let me just put optional. If that, I think that is preferable, optional. Now, this part is very important, please. So, it's important to tell them more about all this, that you want them to already put their delivery address, you know. And if they want to put notes, they can put notes when they're about to deliver their product. Okay, so now, delivery free. This one is very important. So, I just swipe down and see this delivery fee. Very important. I'm going to click add delivery free. So, delivery fee just like shop, you just like, you know, shipping. So if you are in Lagos, let's say for example, if you are in Lagos, I want the fee to be, delivery fee to be 450 naira. I'm going to save that. So Lagos 450 naira. You can actually add more, you know. So you can, when it's all finished saving, you can add more location. So I'm going to click on add delivery fee again. Okay, I think it's doing something for me here. Let me just swap up again. Add delivery fee. So now I'm going to choose just another location. You know, I've already chosen Lagos. Let me just choose if you are in Nigeria, so you know where you are going to deliver. So if you are within Nigeria, I'm going to your fee will be 1,500. Let's just say. So you can be more specific, maybe Ogun State or Southwest. You know, just do that, and that will be fine. As you can see, it is successful. Delivery has been successful. So this I don't have added. You can actually add more and more and more and more and more. All right, so let's go there. The next thing I'm going to do is after purchase. Now, when customers actually purchase things in your store, where do you want to take them to? You see, that says you choose what happened after your customer place and order. Where do you take them to? Do you want to take them to a website or just a thank you page? So if you want to take them to a website, how do you want to take them to your WhatsApp, you know, WhatsApp contact, just to for you to be more familiar with them. You can just put in your WhatsApp contact here, you know, that is ways that has been done. Just click on this edit button and you can add your link. So for example, I'm going to take it to WhatsApp, my WhatsApp contact. I'm going to put wa.me/ my phone number 234-0340-51167. So when customer finish paying, so that you just click on that, or come directly to my contact, my WhatsApp number, and they can actually chat to me up if they want to. Then success. These are success message. I'll just put in thank you for trusting us with your order. You know, just anything like that with your order. So after clicking on that, I just gonna come here and click on save. Hello, our online store, it is already ready, absolutely ready. You can actually begin to publish it. As you can see, everything is ready. So then just click on, you can copy link if you want to copy link. Okay, then just copy link. You can actually preview it, you can preview, but I'm going to click on copy link and just place it in a new tab automatically, so you should see how the thing is. All right, so here it is. You can actually customize the whole link. You just go to blead.com and shorten the link and make it okay. So here we are. So these are our store. These are my store looks exactly like. So you can see the name of my store. When you click on this menu up here, you should open. Okay, it's not open. So you can actually put in your logo. So there should be a place for logo. Maybe you go back to there and see logo being done. You can see this is a very basic and online store where customer can actually place order for products, and you know, things become fully automated. Now, if they want to buy, let's say for example, they want to buy this HP that I've placed there, all they have to do is just read the description, you know, read the how many they want to buy, they want to buy like 3 or 4. They can actually add to, you know, add to bag. When they click add to bag, then they'll be sent to this place where they can actually check out, you know, or they can keep shopping. So you can add more, you know, you get that. So shipping. So let's say the amount is this a gift? So they put the person's name, the last name, and the delivery fee, and they continue to pay. So for example, now if I click on this, not a gift. Let me say this is not a gift. And I put in my address here. Just put in a random address, you know. Then this the amount. Since I'm in Nigeria, you know, I choose the location is Nigeria. But if I choose Lagos, for example, it's not going to be that. So just leave it as that, Nigeria. And I click on continue to pay. So when I click on continue to pay, okay, shipping region is necessary. Okay, I set it that. Let me put in Lagos just to. Okay, Lagos. Oh, come on. Okay, It's Lagos, 415 naira. Select that, and I continue to pay. All right, let somebody pay for you. They can actually activate that. So I'm going to click review and pay. Okay, phone number two is required. Okay, that is required. So this is what your customer is going to go through. Even you doing nothing. So let's see how this item is being done. So I'm going to preview. And so now I'm going to pay. So this is my preview. As you can see, this is what customer is going to see. If you know, I click upload to begin, that's how everything is get like that. Then you can just click on pay. So they can do to pay because you've already created your Paystack account, you have integrated it with your bank account, so everything is just automatic. So when they say pay with card, they want to pay with cash. I'm not going to pay here because this account is live, not in test mode, it's live. Alright, so ladies and gentlemen, you have actually successfully created your own online store without spending money. So wonderful. So ladies and gentlemen, if you have got value in this video, kindly consider subscribing to YouTube channel, like, share, comment below if you have any question. Once again, my name is Daniel Adewaboye. I look forward to see you in the next video. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.